Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass Workshop series where we built the ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with wired, wireless Active Directory and much more. In our previous video, we did an overview of the workflows around OnGuard. As well, we installed the agent on Windows. However, if we check the access tracker, we saw that we had a failing authentication first, and after that we had a missing service match. What we need to do now is we need to create a new web authentication service. So let's go into our services, add a new one. Here we have the web-based health check only. So let's do no role mapping at this point. Here we need to create a new enforcement policy because there's no enforcement policy yet. The default profile for the wired, then we do the disconnect. Then here under the rules, we want to do the same under all conditions. So if the tips posture, so that's where the posture token is. If it exists, so basically it always exists. We do a AOSCX disconnect, and we can also put in a Aruba wireless terminate session. So these are the same, and automatically if this request is coming from a CX switch, it will do a disconnect. If it's coming from the wireless, it will do a terminate session. So you can have multiple enforcements. Let's save. So now we had that service, but it's all at the bottom. Let's move it up. And let's create a new separator as well. We need to have an authentication source. Save. Let's disable. And reorder this one as well. Good. Okay, now let's try again. Do a retry. Okay, and now we don't have any response, and that's expected. Now we can see here that we have a posture request. Posture request. Here we can see a lot of information sent by the agent. And the next is that we need to add a policy to that. We can go here in our services. So first of all, we need to have here posture compliance. Then here we need to create a new posture policy. You can select here the agent. So the NAP agent, it's no longer supported. So we'll use the OnGuard agent, Windows, Linux, macOS. So we'll leave it on Windows for now. We don't want to do any restrictions. Then here we have the posture plugins, and there are multiple plugins. So for example, if we take the security health validator, this will check basically the Windows Security Center. So if in Windows you see that exclamation mark that something is not good, that's this one. So we can turn it on here. So that's the security health validator, the Windows system health validator. This is more on the versions. So which versions do you want to allow on the network, and you can, if you want, have a certain service pack. So this is where we can do a lot more. So here per version you can set it up, but for Windows 10 we need Windows 10 checks. Then here we can check for services that are there or not there, processes. So let's create one to test where we have notepad.exe. And this is the display name. So if there is an error about this process, you will see this. We'll see that later on. Let's here check the antivirus. So check there is an antivirus on. And this can go much deeper than the previous setting. So you can here check for specific types of antivirus. But you can also check allow any product. Same for the firewall. Okay, so this is pretty basic. We do antivirus firewall check, and that's all. Then under the rules, we can assign our posture tokens. And what's pretty normal is that if you have all system health validators or security health validators, if all pass, then you assign the healthy token. And if one or more fails, you can use the infected, for example. So these tokens, you can assign them whatever you want. So now we should be able to add the posture policy to our service. Default posture token is unknown. Let's save this. Now we can go back to our client. And now we can see our health status is healthy. So if we check in the access tracker, what we see is that we have the posture status of healthy at this point. So next step is that we need to link this together to the .1x authentication. You can see we have the posture status in the WebAuth, but we don't have it in the MacAuth or the .1x. And that is because we need to configure something for that. If we go to our services, wired, then here under the enforcement, we have an option to use cached roles and posture attributes from previous session. If we enable this one, retry. Now we should see the OnGuard posture. And now we can see here the cached status of the posture. And you remembered that we made a check on the notepad. So let's get back to our client. We can run notepad over here. And now either we can wait because there is a periodic check, or we can just press the retry. And we can see immediately that we have the health status of quarantine. So stop the following process. Notepad insecure. So this is the label that we put in the policy. You can basically put in anything there to make it clear to the end users what they need to do. Now let's have a look in the policy manager. So here we had our latest posture, and we can see that indeed we have the infected, and for the cached one, we have infected as well. In the next video, we will start responding on this so we can have a different policy for infected and for healthy clients. But that's for next video. Hope you liked this video. If so, please press the like button and consider to subscribe to the channel. As well, if you have any questions, you can either put them in the AirHeads community or in the comments section under this video. Thanks a lot for watching.